I block all email from a specific domain in Gmail? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Unlike some other email services, like outlook.com, I believe, lets you basically block all email from a specific domain, it's not clear how to do that in Gmail. You can easily block individual email addresses, but there's nothing obvious about blocking an entire domain. However, that doesn't mean you can't do it. Let me show you how. Now, I want to be clear before we start. All from a domain is a very, very important concept. The domain is that part of the email address after the at sign. So for the email address leo@askleo.com, the domain is askleo.com. For example, @gmail.com, it's gmail.com. Blocking all email from a domain means that no email from anyone sending from an email address on that domain will get to you. Blocking all email from gmail.com, for example, prevents anyone with a Gmail address from reaching you. Hence, we want to do this carefully, selectively. Now, there are scenarios where this actually makes sense. Typically, they're spam-related, where blocking an entire domain can actually work. If you're being flooded with email from some obscure email domain, especially if it's from overseas, there may, in fact, be no downside at all to blocking every email address on that domain. The upside for doing that would potentially be a tamer email inbox. So, it's a Gmail filter trick is what we're going to look at. Over here in Gmail, we are looking for email that comes in. And sure enough, here's an email that has come in. Let's assume for a moment that this is spam. It's from a domain I own, randomisp.com. But it is in fact something that we don't want. And maybe we're getting flooded by email from this domain and we don't want any of them. The place to start is in the search box of all places. What we're going to do is we're going to type in from colon paren @randomisp.com, where you would replace randomisp.com with the domain that you're having problems with. Now, once we do that, we'll go ahead and click on search. And sure enough, it's showing me the emails that I have basically here and in my archives. Double check those results, because whatever happens next, these emails are going to be the ones you end up blocking. So as long as everything in this list is email that you want to block, and you don't see any emails that you might want to keep, this is the place to go. Now, with that from domain in still in the search box, we'll click on this slider icon, the show search options. Now, this is showing us what our search criteria are. All this really has done is translated the from, colon, etc. that we typed into the search box into separate fields. And you can see in the from box, it just says @randomisp.com. There's really nothing that needs to be changed here. This is fine the way it is. You can refine it if you want to, but for the most part, this is what we're looking for. So all we really need to do then is click on create filter. Now, this is allowing us to tell Gmail what we want done to email that comes in that matches that search criteria. There's a lot of different things we could choose to do, but if we don't want to see this email from this domain ever, click on delete it. Click on create filter, and you're done. You can now delete these guys or archive them or do whatever you want to. There's a problem, or at least a shortcoming here. What I would have preferred to be able to do is to mark it as spam. But you'll notice that in those filter options, the word spam never appears. You can't filter something to be marked as spam automatically. In my case, deleting works just fine. But that way, any more email that comes in from that domain will be automatically deleted. Okay, what if you decide you don't want that filter anymore, or you need to change something about that filter? Maybe sometime later you realize, oh, there is this email address on that domain that I do want to continue to get email from. Click on the gear icon. Click on See All Settings, and then click on Filters and Blocked Addresses. And here it is. This is the filter that we just created. If it matches from @randomisp, do this, delete it. You can edit it, which will bring up the edit box that we played with before. Make whatever changes you want to it, and then change the actions you want to have happen to it. Or you could delete it completely. If there's an email address on this domain that you want to receive, then unfortunately, this type of filter will not work for you. There's no way to say delete everything but this email address. So if that's the case, if you suddenly realize that you are getting email from, say, leo@randomisp.com, and you want to keep it, you want to be able to receive that, then this filter is not the filter for you, and you need to then go ahead and just delete the filter. And now we're back to where we started. So bottom line, while mark as spam is probably the most used approach to dealing with spam, and it's the approach that I recommend you default to if you can, if you're getting an inordinate amount of email from different email addresses on the same domain, and you know that you never need anything from that domain, you can now block, automatically delete, all of the email from that domain. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/174792. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.